Hello friends, today we are starting with the new topic of lipid, that is conjugated lipid, which is the second class of lipid. So that what is mean by conjugated lipid and its different example and its overall information we will take up in this video. So that next, conjugated lipid. So what is mean by conjugated lipid? There is something else other than lipid which is present in the lipid part, that is called as conjugated lipid. So that how can we write here, conjugated lipid means lipid plus non-lipid part. Lipid means no doubt it contains fatty acid plus glycerol, and non-lipid part means it is prosthetic group, you can say, means other than lipid. Okay, that is called as conjugated lipid. To understand very well, let us take some example. So that the first example is, phospholipid. So as you know very well, phospholipid is present in the universal membrane, that is called plasma membrane. In the plasma membrane, phospholipid present in bilayer nature, means it's still facing with each other. So in phospholipid, that is phosphoric acid is the non-lipid part and it is attached with the lipid, that is fatty acid and glycerol. You know very well, fluid mosaic model which was given by Singer and Nicholson. If you are able to recall the structure of plasma membrane, you can draw here the phospholipid molecule. So this is what lipid, right? This one is that glycerol, okay, and this one is that lipid. So this is a lipid part, this one is that fatty acid, so glycerol plus fatty acid together form lipid, and at the tip of glycerol, the non-lipid part is prosthetic group which is to be attached, that is called as phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid. In this way, this phosphoric acid and lipid together form phospholipid. Understand? The interesting features of phospholipid is that it is an amphipathic molecule. See, it is amphipathic. Now, amphipathic nature means what? Actually, see, this is a glycerol and fatty acids are hydrophilic. Hydrophilic means water loving. They can soluble in water. But the fatty acid which form a two tail, that is hydrophobic. Hydrophobic means water hating. They are insoluble in water. And as you know, the property of lipid is that, means fatty acid, it is insoluble in water but soluble in organic solvent. When in the particular molecule, if you consider phospholipid, if hydrophilic and hydrophobic, both the natures or both the properties are present, such a together property is called as amphipathy. Okay, so this is about what? Phospholipid, right? Now, let us understand the second example, that is glycolipid. Glycolipid. Now, in the glycolipid, the two components are present. One is carbohydrate, which is the non-lipid part, and second, lipid. Okay, now let us understand where the glycolipid is present. Again, you recall the structure of plasma membrane, that is phospholipid bilayer. Okay, if I draw, this is the phospholipid bilayer, and this each phospholipid molecule is a diglyceride, you can say. This is the phospholipid. And it is the trilaminar structure, if you see, means the phospholipid bilayer present in between the protein membrane. Here two types of proteins are present. Extrinsic protein, suppose this is extrinsic protein, then intrinsic protein, this one is that intrinsic protein. Okay, so what is mean by extrinsic protein? The protein which are loosely embedded in the phospholipid bilayer and which can easily remove, that is called as extrinsic protein, which is also called as peripheral protein. And what is meant by intrinsic protein? The protein which is tightly embedded in the phospholipid bilayer and which cannot be easily removed. Understand? In this way, those carbohydrate means in a carbohydrate oligosaccharide topic, we talked about when oligosaccharide attach with protein, then means oligosaccharide never found in alone. It is either attached to the lipid or protein. So what I say, if carbohydrate means these oligosaccharide attach with protein, suppose this is protein, then this is protein. It is called as glycoprotein, but our main focus is to understand about glycolipid. And when the oligosaccharide is attached to the lipid part, then it is called as glycolipid. Understand? So this is about what? Glycolipid. Then next, sphingolipid, third example. Now, what is meant by sphingolipid? Sphingolipid means lipid plus nitrogenous bases. Okay, any type of nitrogenous bases may present, either A or T or G or C. Adenine, guanine, adenine, thymine, guanine and cytosine. Understand? And if RNA nitrogenous bases, instead of thymine, uracil is present. No doubt. So if nitrogenous bases combine with the lipid, then such a lipid is called as sphingolipid. And where it is present, actually it is present in some cell of plasma membrane and nervous cells. Present in the plasma membrane of some nervous tissue. It is present in the plasma membrane of some nervous tissue. And the last example is that lipoprotein. So lipoprotein means what? Here, no doubt it is very easy to understand. Lipid plus protein is present. This is about what? Lipoprotein. So in this way, conjugated, I recall the whole topic again. Conjugated lipid means it is the lipid plus non-lipid part. Non-lipid part means something else may present. Means it is a prosthetic group. It is either carbohydrate or protein or nitrogenous base, etc. On the basis of this, we understood some examples. First of all, phospholipid, glycolipid, sphingolipid, and then lipoprotein. I also trying to explain its function of these some conjugated lipid. Understand?